How to balance detachment and involvement? We all play many roles and have many responsibilities in our lives as children, parents, friends, students, or professionals. Each role requires discipline, commitment, and full involvement. Yet, to excel, we must also practice detachment. This poses a dilemma. How do we balance involvement and detachment? Our attitudes towards detachment and involvement often stray from the truth and mislead us. We tend to get attached to people and detach from work, when in reality, we need to practice detachment with people and involvement with work. When we mix these up and have attachment to the action, we start expecting, leading to negative emotions like agitation, despair, or giving up. To overcome this tendency, we must approach every action with great mindfulness and care, being devoted and diligent in our duties while focusing fully on the task at hand. A mother cannot give in to every cry of her child, despite her love. She must detach herself and do what is right for the child. Similarly, we cannot be overly attached and involved at the same time, as attachment will prevent us from fulfilling our responsibilities. Take the example of Arjuna and Sri Krishna in the Kurukshetra war. Arjuna's dilemma on the battlefield illustrates the importance of duty over personal attachments. Tormented by the prospect of killing his own family, he turned to Lord Krishna for guidance. Krishna advised Arjuna to do his duty detachedly, emphasizing that proper fulfillment of one's duty requires non-attachment. Sri Krishna exemplified balancing engagement and detachment. With the Gopikas, he was playful and joyful, yet in the battlefield, he showed absolute discipline and detachment. Despite his varying roles, he consistently upheld dharma through wisdom and equanimity. We all have many duties and relationships, but like Krishna, we must engage fully in each role while remaining inwardly detached.